I'm a stay-at-home mom of three girls, and so my day consists basically of diaper changes and mess cleanups and refereeing sibling rivalries, school pickups, school drop-offs, all of these things that most moms do. And it can sometimes feel a little insignificant, kind of ordinary. And recently I had this moment when I was cleaning up after breakfast. I was vacuuming crumbs up from under the baby's high chair. And if you've ever watched a small child eat, you know why I was vacuuming crumbs, because a broom is basically useless at this point. And so I'm vacuuming up these crumbs, and this thought just crept into my mind, and it said, this is not what successful people do. And you know, that moment, that thought threatened to crush me. It threatened to ruin my day and ruin my attitude. But I'm very thankful that I know this truth, that just because it's less doesn't mean it's less than. And when we get this picture of where our significance is in the book of Ruth, really, she was ordinary. In fact, she was actually less than ordinary. She was a foreigner. She was a former pagan. She was a woman and a widow. So she didn't have a whole lot going for her. And she was in this new place. She didn't have family, except for Naomi. And she didn't have a place. She didn't have what we would expect successful people to have. But God saw her. God didn't see her ordinary. He saw someone and something that he could use. And I'm so grateful for this story of redemption. I am so grateful that God saw this woman, because he saw her, he can see us too. He uses the story of Ruth and Naomi and Boaz to paint this beautiful picture of redemption that we can have through Christ if we believe in him. And that's why I wrote Redeemed, Extraordinary Grace for Ordinary People.